Welcome to Pixarize's scene for Hereditary Fructose Intolerance, part of our playlist on metabolic disorders. Hereditary fructose intolerance is a disease defined by an inability to properly metabolize fructose, the primary carbohydrate in fruit. Therefore, our scene is set in the bedroom of the fruit ninja, whose mortal enemy is fruit and the fructose contained within it. We might not have a ton of time before our fruit ninja's parents confiscate his weaponry and clean up his mess, so let's not waste a moment. I mentioned that hereditary fructose intolerance is a disease characterized by defective fructose metabolism. We'll start by explaining how exactly the metabolic machinery here goes awry. Let's direct our attention to the broken owl doll next to our little fruit ninja. It looks like he was in the wrong place at the wrong time. That, or he was aligned with the evil fruit empire and had to perish. Either way, the owl doll is broken, and that will help us remember that it is the aldolase enzyme, specifically aldolase B, that is defective in hereditary fructose intolerance. This mutation is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern. At Pixarize, we symbolize autosomal recessive inheritance with small vehicles like smart cars or toy cars. Notice that we've included a small toy car on the shelf to remind us that fructose intolerance is autosomal recessive. Now that we've identified aldolase B as the defective enzyme, let's talk about its role in fructose metabolism. After fructose is phosphorylated by fructokinase to form fructose 1-phosphate, a reaction we discuss in detail in our scene on essential fructosuria, it is then split by aldolase B into dihydroxyacetone phosphate, or DHAP, and glyceraldehyde. When our aldol is broken, as it is in our image, this reaction can't proceed, and we're left with a buildup of fructose 1-phosphate. This aberrant accumulation of phosphorylated fructose has a number of downstream effects, and we'll go through each of them now. First, let's explain why this child's room is full of foxes, each holding fruit in their mouths. It's because behind every game of Fruit Ninja, there's an intense cleanup operation led by our fruit foxes. As fructose 1-phosphate accumulates, it ends up sequestering cellular stores of available phosphate. Since foxes are a recurring symbol for phosphate, notice how all of these adorable foxes are completely occupied by the fruit in our ninja's bedroom. That's to remind us that in hereditary fructose intolerance, fructose 1-phosphate buildup reduces the availability of free phosphate. No free foxes, no free phosphate. I still can't get over how cute they are. I'm sure you're all aware that phosphate is a massively important molecule involved in a number of key metabolic pathways. What's most relevant in hereditary fructose intolerance is that reduced free phosphate results in the inhibition of both gluconeogenesis and glycogenolysis, processes that are responsible for creating and mobilizing glucose. So you can imagine how the inhibition of these pathways would lead to symptoms of hypoglycemia, like lethargy and seizure. The low levels of glucose seen in fructose intolerance are represented by this fallen canister of sugar. It looks like our sweet-toothed foxes have already gotten to it because that thing is empty. At Pixarize, we like to symbolize decreased laboratory levels lower down in the image, so this empty fallen glucose canister and the foxes roaming the floor should help you remember low levels of glucose and free intracellular phosphate in the setting of fructose intolerance. The symptoms of hereditary fructose intolerance occur following the ingestion of fructose or sucrose, since sucrose is broken down into fructose and glucose. This generally happens after infants first ingest fruit, honey, or juice, and we can see that our Shinobi baby, is slicing through all sorts of fruit and a honey-filled hive. His parents really need to childproof their kitchen. I mean, come on, this kid should not have access to this stuff. If we look on the shelf below our autosomal recessive toy car, we can see that he's even tossed a knife into a watermelon, causing it to vomit its juicy innards. Boom, headshot. This R-rated image should help remind you that vomiting is another presenting symptom, along with hypoglycemic restlessness, tremors, lethargy, and seizures. The treatment for hereditary fructose intolerance is pretty simple. Patients just need to stop eating fructose and sucrose. However, if the disease goes undiagnosed or isn't properly treated, patients with fructose intolerance can undergo liver damage. Fructose 1-phosphate buildup is hepatotoxic. Take a look at the yellow fruit juice that is splattered onto our ninja. It can be hard to stay clean as a slayer of fruit. This yellow skin discoloration should remind you of the finding of jaundice. If left unmanaged, repeated fructose-induced hepatic damage and scarring can lead to cirrhosis, the development of a fibrotic, rock-hard liver. If we take a look to the left of our toy car on the shelf, we can see a liver-shaped rock there to help us recall this potential complication. Do kids still have pet rocks? I hope so. I had one. Finally, let's cover a couple of important urological findings in hereditary fructose intolerance. Take a look at that recycling or reducing bin full of fruit. You might recognize it from our video on essential fructosuria. It's here in this scene to remind us that a test for reducing agents in the urine will be positive in fructose intolerance, since fructose is a reducing carbohydrate. And another recurring symbol, the negative pregnancy test, is neatly tucked away in the Shinobi baby's diaper. I have no idea why he has a pregnancy test on his person, but then again, I can't explain how he got his hands on a katana either. Looks like mom hasn't been keeping a close enough eye on her things. What I do know is that the negative urine pregnancy stick symbolizes a negative sugar test by urine dipstick, since urine dipsticks test only for the presence of glucose and not fructose. And that's all we've got for hereditary fructose intolerance. To quickly summarize, it's a disease characterized by the accumulation of intracellular fructose 1-phosphate due to a defect in the aldolase B enzyme. Patients will develop hypoglycemia and vomiting after ingesting fructose and can go on to develop cirrhosis of the liver if the disease isn't properly treated. Once you've watched our video on essential fructosuria, you'll have all the tools you'll need to ace board questions on fructose metabolism, become a great doctor, raise a family, and keep sharp objects and rabies away from your psychotic child. Until next time!
Thanks for watching. For more videos like these, click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also check out the interactive version of this image at pixarize.com by following the link in the description. If you like what we're doing, share with your friends on social media, and we'll keep making great content like this. We'll see you next time.